Good morning, everyone. Hope everyone had a wonderful and safe 4th of July. I know we did. It was very relaxing. Got a lot of stuff done around the house we needed to do. Even got a batch of soap made. So it's good. So, as you can tell from the title, the July Elder's Letters are out. And this may be quite lengthy because there's a lot of information here, and I wanted to cover a few other things and some quotes from Watchtower and stuff like that. But I want to thank all of you, our old subscribers, and welcome to our new subscribers. Thank you so much for, plastering that Enemies of God video I did the other day all over the place, because that was so disturbing, and I think a lot of others are realizing how disturbing it is. And we have reports coming in. I know Mike mentioned it in his video yesterday that JW sitting in their Zoom meeting watching the convention are like, oh my God, and just shut it off. Yeah. So, anyway, Elder's Letters. Announcement July 1st. For selected congregations in the United States branch territory, and I want to thank Atlantis and all of you others who have sent me these letters. I appreciate it very much. So, this is for selected congregations in the United States. Shouldn't it be for all congregations? No, it's for selected ones. World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Project at Ramapo, New York. As was previously announced at the 2019 annual meeting and in the September 2021 midweek meeting video, Ramapo, make yourself available. The governing body has approved a World Headquarters construction project at Ramapo, New York. No, you were waiting for your plans to be approved by the Ramapo or the town of Ramapo, government officials. It is truly exciting to see that the rapid growth in Jehovah's organization is creating a need for expanded theocratic facilities to support audio-video production. Now I'm going to pause right there because I did a video a couple of weeks ago about their Legal Learning Studios new website and YouTube channel, how they were doing videos for lawyers, teaching lawyers of the world, not just Jehovah's Witnesses. So, how much is going to be used for the religious part and how much is going to be used for their legal learning studios? Just wondering. And are they going to tell Jehovah's Witnesses, oh, well, instead of just religious videos for the good news, we're also going to be doing legal videos teaching the world's lawyers how to fight these cases on freedom of religion? My humble opinion. Number two, many brothers and sisters have experienced great joy in being able to participate in the construction of facilities used for Jehovah's worship. No, they're not. How does videos for, lawyers part of Jehovah's worship? Whatever. Whether we can help out on a building site or not, all of us can have the privilege of supporting such projects through our voluntary donations. And there you go. It's all about give us money for all of this building and real estate empire we're building. Oh, disgusting. As a reminder, an additional donation type on donate.jw.org, and an additional contribution box will be available as a means for you to express your appreciation for this exciting endeavor. Why don't you take the billions of dollars you're raking in on other projects, like selling of property and your stocks and bonds and investments and hedge funds? Why don't you use some of that to pay for your building projects instead of asking the rank and file who are already under tremendous stress from the horrible inflation in this country? I digress. Online contributions may be made at donate.jw.org www.jw.org by selecting your country and congregation and then selecting the World Headquarters Audio Video Construction donation type. If your congregation has a Kingdom Hall or an Assembly Hall project in progress, the contribution box for the World Headquarters Construction Project will be identified after your local project is completed. We are confident that when the new World Headquarters facility is completed, it will significantly contribute to divine education and give a great shout of praise to our loving and generous God, Jehovah. And then for selected coordinators of the body of elders, please ensure the announcement for congregations is read at the next midweek meeting. Thereafter, it should be posted on the information board. Number two, additional contribution box for World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Project. Please ensure that the contribution box for receiving donations for the World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Project is made available at the appropriate time. For selected secretaries, World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Project in Ramapo, New York, please provide the account servant with a copy of attachment below entitled Instructions for World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Project Contributions and review the instructions with him. And then they have the instructions for this new contribution. And they also have the accounting sheet of how to fill it out. I'm just going to skip down to, probably the last third of part one. In addition to using the contribution box label provided by the branch office, God, they even give you labels. The body of elders may choose to label the box World Headquarters Audio Video Construction. The box and label should remain in place until notification is received that the World Headquarters Audio Video Project has been completed. Contributions from the World Headquarters Audio Video Construction Box, that's a long tongue twister, should be collected at the end of each meeting in the same manner as all the other contributions and should be recorded as a separate line item on the transaction record S24. And that's on here and blah, blah, blah. They give instructions on how to do that. The accounting sheet there. Oh my goodness. Now, I also want to announce for the Hispanic side of the movement, thank you, Aunt Nellie, very much. They are all very happy that the protest this Saturday, July 9th, Brazil, the country of Brazil, is being added to the protest. So if you're in Brazil now and you would like to join that protest, you know, contact anyone in the Hispanic side of the movement, because there's several who are, you know, doing videos, and I'm sure your XJW Hispanic forums and websites will have this information also. But we're very happy that Brazil is being added. So I believe that's four countries now. What a tremendous voice. Okay, so I have another announcements and reminders here. July 2022 for elders. Slideshows and videos at weddings. I thought this was funny. We have received reports that personal slideshows and videos presented before or after some wedding talks have not dignified and in a few cases were outlandish. As a reminder, the Shepherd Book, Chapter 27, Paragraph 5 states, if any video footage is used before or after a wedding talk, it should be in good taste. The entire occasion should be spiritually upbuilding and dignified, whether the wedding is held at the Kingdom Hall or via video conference. As part of the preparations, the elder who will preside at the wedding may provide suggestions to the couple on how they can adjust a slideshow or video to harmonize with Bible principles. Oh, good Lord. The aforementioned direction regarding slideshows and videos also applies in connection with a funeral talk. Public Information Department. The Public Information Department, PID, at the branch office officially represents Jehovah's Witnesses to government officials, academics, the media, and other entities. The PID's responsibility is to assist in providing accurate information about our beliefs, activities, and history. Yeah, right. lie, lie, lie. And we've seen examples of this all over the media. Oh, good Lord. And Hendricks is really good about, you know, being in the PR and spewing this BS. In addition, regional local spokesmen have been appointed throughout the branch territory and work under the direction of PID. If a media representative contacts a congregation to request an interview or comments, please request his name, his contact information, the name of the media outlet he represents, and the deadline for a reply. Inform him that his request will be given consideration, but do not commit to providing a response. In most cases, two elders should then immediately contact the PID, which will provide further direction. The same general approach should be taken if government officials, academic institutions, or non-governmental organizations contact the congregation to obtain information. So what are they trying to hide? If they were open about all things, the elders, the COs, the Jehovah's Witnesses, all of them would be happy to discuss these things. No. Because most of the time the media is contacting them about their CSA cases. And this is why I say that. If any of the above entities contact the congregation about a matter related to a current or past judicial case to the standing of a publisher in the congregation, yep, or to the congregation's handling of a theocratic matter, two elders should immediately contact the service department for direction. Don't want to get any information out that they're trying to hide. Same thing with publishers, blah, blah, blah. This direction will be included in a future revision of the Shepherd Book. Security at meetings. Jehovah is deeply interested in protecting his servants. Acts of extreme violence can erupt without warning, even in areas where there had previously been no disturbances. Therefore, we urge you to remain alert to the security of those who attend our meetings. Congregation meetings, attendants should be alert to what is taking place not only inside the Kingdom Hall, but also outside. Please convey this reminder as well as the key points found in the Shepherd Book, chapter 20, paragraphs 38 to 39. Okay, for coordinators of the bodies of elders, midweek meeting part, the week of July 11th, please ensure that the brother who is assigned the midweek meeting part set goals for the new service year, move to where the need is greater during the week of July 11th, mentions the following. At times, publishers consider moving so they can live closer to a Bethel facility or a branch construction project. The scriptural principles and practical suggestions in this article will be very helpful for anyone considering such a move. For service overseers, the 2023 Public Magazines, we are pleased to inform you that the governing body decided that one new issue of the public edition of the Watchtower and one new issue of Awake will be produced for 2023. That is pathetic. And then they have a list here. It has been decided to feature two issues of the Watchtower and two issues of Awake from previous years. Listed below are the subjects of the public magazines that will be featured in 2023. And it looks like they have a list of previous articles that they're going to use for these reprints. Wow. Now, I was looking for something else and I came across this. This is the 1999 Awake Bond Volume. And we're going to go over to April 8th, 1999. And the name of this article is Children in Crisis. When I saw this, it's like, oh my God. Watchtower talking about themselves and how hypocritical. Page 11. First column, about the halfway down, right above the subheading, The Only Real Solution. I'm going to read that second to the last paragraph before the subheading. Now think about this. This is Watchtower telling people this. Think of the heartbreak of parents who have discovered too late that their children have been abused by trusted clergymen, teachers, or even close family members. It would be good for you as a parent to ask yourself, does my church tolerate or cover up child abuse? Oh my God. So they're telling Jehovah's Witnesses back in 1999? Well, not even that. They're telling the general public. If your church allows it. See, this is when a lot of this with the Catholic Church came out. Do you see how hypocritical they are? Does my church tolerate or cover it up? CSA. Is my religion holding firmly to high moral principles? So Jehovah's Witnesses, ask yourself. If the organization, Mother, your religion is covering this up and tolerating it, should you stay in it? Are they holding firmly to high moral principles? Well, not if they try to cover it up. And look at the Pinkava Scott case in Illinois. They're still elders in good standing. They're still giving talks at their local kingdom hall and at the assemblies. So is that holding to high moral principles? Answers to such questions could help you to make wise choices in protecting your children or getting out of your religion. Disturbing. Love you all, and thank you so much for watching. Bye.